We want to square a sum and difference involving radicals, or in this case, square roots. The main thing to remember here is there are no shortcuts. We cannot just square the first term and square the second term. We actually have to expand this and then multiply. So for the first example, the square root of 11 plus 9 squared is equal to the square root of 11 plus 9 times the square root of 11 plus 9. Notice how we have two factors of the square root of 11 plus 9. Now we'll multiply this out like we normally would. So we can think of foiling this, or double distribution, meaning we distribute the square root of 11 here and here, and then the 9 here and here. So we have four products. The first product we have, square root of 11 times square root of 11. So that'll be the square root of 11 times 11. We'll come back and simplify this. Next, we have square root of 11 times 9. Notice the 9 is not underneath the square root. So this will be 9 square root of 11. Notice the next product will also be 9 square root of 11. And the last product we have, 9 times 9, which is equal to 81. And now we'll simplify and combine like terms. So this is a perfect square. So the square root of 11 squared is equal to 11. Notice these next two terms are like radicals because they contain a factor of square root 11. So to combine these, we add the coefficients. Since 9 plus 9 is equal to 18, this sum is 18 square root of 11. And then we still have plus 81. And now we have two more like terms, the constants. 11 plus 81 is 92. So we have 92 plus 18 square root of 11. Let's take a look at a second example. Again, there are no shortcuts here. We cannot just square the first term and square the second term. We have to expand this and then multiply. So we have 2 square root 5 minus square root 2 times the quantity 2 square root 5 minus square root 2. Again, we'll have four products. So we can think of distributing here and here, as well as here and here. So the first product, we have 2 square root 5 times 2 square root 5. So 2 times 2 is 4. And we'll have the square root of 5 times 5, which we'll simplify, but we'll come back to that. The next product is 2 square root 5 times negative square root 2. So we're going to multiply the 5 and the 2 underneath the square root. So we'll have minus 2 times the square root of 5 times 2. Next we have negative square root 2 times positive 2 square root 5. That's minus 2 times the square root of 2 times 5, or 5 times 2. And the last product we have, negative square root 2 times negative square root 2, which is going to be a positive, or plus, square root 2 times 2. Now we'll simplify. Well, the square root of 5 squared simplifies to 5, so this is equal to 4 times 5. These two middle terms, again, are like terms. Notice how they both have a factor of square root 10. And since negative 2 minus 2 is negative 4, we'll have minus 4 square root 10 plus the square root of 2 times 2, or 2 squared, is equal to 2. So 4 times 5 would be 20, and 20 plus 2 is 22, so we have 22 minus 4 square root 10. So the main thing to remember here is that when squaring a sum or difference involving a square root or radicals, there are no shortcuts. We need to write it out in expanded form and then multiply.